This one's for the Black Diamond Trophy. If you consider yourself a college football fan, you won't want to miss it. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Virginia Tech is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 29-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Just throws this one away. From their own 29-yard line. Second down. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Quick throw. He's tackled at the 44-yard line. And a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and a quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
From their own 44-yard line. First down. Nice run to the outside. Steps out at the 48-yard line. From the 48-yard line, it's third down. Brought down around the 49-yard line.
Good solid defense there to force him into a fourth down situation.
This is a great punt blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. And this one is a beauty. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Nice run there as they work the outside. From their own 25-yard line. Second down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He's to the 40. Tackle made at the 43-yard line.
Defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
From their own 39-yard line, it's second down.
Seven's a Mike. Mike seven. Cut.
With a quick throw, it's knocked away, incomplete.
Surprising to me that the secondary was in such good position. I thought the play call had him fooled at first, but a nice play by the D.
Caught, and this is going to be a first down. He's hit and taken down. First and 10, ball on the 43-yard line. He's at the 30, and he's taken down at the 27-yard line.
They've obviously found a formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
Tackle at about the 25-yard line. From the 25-yard line, second down.
Mike seven. Ready, green and yard.
Go. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. Shakes off a tackle. And that sets them up with a first and goal. This is the ninth play of the current drive. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receiver. They're at the eight. It's second down. He goes at the one. It's the 11th play of the drive.
Check.
They're crowding the line. Somebody jumped early down there. They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
This is from the 5-yard line. It's third and goal. Quick strike to the receiver. Touchdown. A well-drawn up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
Boy, that's a big play and a big touchdown for the offense. But the one thing that that play requires is time. The quarterback had time to make a decision to eventually make that long throw for the touchdown. The defense has got to do a much better job of getting pressure on the quarterback and not allowing him to sit back there and make those throws.
Virginia Tech ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Hokies really took care of business on defense that first time out, Kirby.
One of the great traditions of college football is this defense and the way they play with such passion and enthusiasm in this environment. We're seeing that again today.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change the game plan. Nice gain as he works the right side. He keeps it on the option and picks up maybe four. Second down and six. Ball on the 29-yard line. Slings it. And that one's fallen incomplete. An empty backfield with five wide receivers.
Let's go.
Complete. He's got room. That's a great tackle at the 43.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43. He's taken down around the 39-yard line.
Mike four.
Quick pass. They'll bring him down
at about the 41.
They're stopped 2 yards behind the line.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
From the 41-yard line, second down. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's tackled
around the 34-yard line.
An exciting first quarter comes to an end. 7-0, Virginia Tech. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. They make the stop
at about the 27-yard line.
I think he just barely got it. That's a great job by both the quarterback and receiver to keep this drive alive.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Ready, run, 69.
Run.
And he's tackled at the positive yardage. From the 23-yard line, second down. Gets out to around the 15. 10th play of the drive.
47 mark.
There's a strike complete. He's down. So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. First and goal, and a touchdown ties it, folks. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Here's the 12th play of the drive. Now he pitches it. He tackles him for a loss.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
It's 3rd and goal from the 5. Let's see if they can put this one in. A little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call. They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on 3rd down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
Steps up and goes down.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Kicks up, and they tack on 3 points. The Mountaineers, his quarterback taken off earlier, down on the sideline right now. Doesn't look like he's in that much pain, and I would bet that we'll see him back in the game before the day is over. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. With 1 quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these 2 squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Virginia Tech is up by 4. Here's an opening. Makes it out to about the 36. First and 10. Ball on the 36. Passes it to the middle of the field. He's tackled at the 47. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Fires to the wideout, first down. He goes out of bounds around the 42-yard line. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
From the 42-yard line, first down. And they'll bring him down behind the line.
You're not going to see this very often from this running back. He just got gobbled up pretty deep in the backfield.
He's going to try and scramble. Brought down around the 44-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32. And he's tackled right away. Quick throw, and he tackles him hard at the 23-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Virginia Tech holds a 4-point lead. Tackle made right around the 22-yard line. This is the ninth play of this drive.
Tight left. Four down. Mike seven.
Ready. Wide 80.
Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of one.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. The kick is up, and he got it. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. After a decent run up the gut, Brown picks up about 7 yards on the halfback draw. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Let's go! 180!
Setting up blockers, or running back's got it on the screen. He's knocked out of bounds around the 37-yard line. So the completion goes for about 5 yards and a first down.
And that's just great execution on that short pass play.
There's the strike complete, and he hits him hard at the 46-yard line. Short yardage situation here, second down and one.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
Throws it to the halfback on the screen, and he's taken down at the 47-yard line. The Mountaineers using their third and final timeout. I guess he'll throw this one as far as he can and hope for a miracle. Going deep, lays it out there. Doesn't get there. A great first half comes to a close. 10-3, Hokies.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. East Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
Both of these offenses are known for producing big plays. It's one thing to produce a big play against the average run-of-the-mill defense that you see mostly in college football. And it is quite another to do it against the type of talent these teams are facing.
I think they're seeing that, aren't they? It seems like you just bump your head up against the wall. Nothing's going your way. And it forces you to be extremely patient. But when I start looking at these defenses, I'm seeing a lot of guys that you could probably drop into Madden right now, and they would have a huge impact on the ball game. Next level guys, full-grown men that you don't want to mess with. So there's a lot of little boys out there playing college football, but there's some next-level guys that are playing some grown man football.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brett and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So we're just about ready to return to action. Virginia Tech is up a score. Throws incomplete. And there wasn't anyone in the vicinity.
I think the ball just slipped out on him.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that.
Check tight right. Solo out there. Check the outs out there.
Four down. Seven's a Mike.
He's on the run. Tackle around the 30-yard line. Well, they try to keep it on the ground for the first down.
You know, Brad, here the defense just steps up and makes a play, stopping them and bringing up fourth down.
Moore is the punter. And this one is a beauty. He's tackled at the 42. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on their own 44. Looks to the back and can't connect.
That was textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. And down he goes at the 48. Let's see if he aims for the sideline and tries to get this thing down deep in their own territory. Quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Virginia Tech is up 7. Nice run to the left there. Second and 3. Ball on the 30-yard line. Gains his way to the 39-yard line.
Tight end right.
makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. It's second and 10. Ball on the 39. Gonna go across the middle. Caught at the 30. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him on the first and goal. Hoping to go up two touchdowns here. He's flushed and they got it. From the 7-yard line, it's second down. Virginia Tech is up by a touchdown. He's taken down right around the 2-yard line.
From a short distance, he had great blocking up front on that play.
And he converts the extra point. A 7-play, 78-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. The score now, 17-3. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 21-yard line. The Hokies continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
Not much luck the last time this offense had the ball.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
They'll bring him down at the 30.
Nice play, baby, nice play.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
They come out in a 5-wide set. There's a laser across the middle. He's to the 40. First and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete. The stop around the 45-yard line. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. They come out in an empty backfield. And he's tackled at the 48-yard line. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. Virginia Tech showing right now that they are not content to sit back and just watch their lead disappear. They're adding to it.
Boy, they're clicking right now on offense. They found their rhythm, and as you said, they're not looking back. They're trying to extend this lead and try to put this game out of reach.
he's hit immediately. From their own 36-yard line, it's first down. And he's immediately tackled. We head to the fourth quarter. Virginia Tech's lead is 2 touchdowns. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up.
Seven's a Mike, Mike seven.
Fires it out. He's tackled right around the 48-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 43.
Mike seven.
The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. 5 wide receivers in the formation. And that one's incomplete. That one sailed on it.
He wanted his receiver, but I think that may have slipped out of his hands.
Moore is waiting for the snap. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out. Dumps it out left to the running back. Brought down around the 22-yard line. Second and 8. Ball on their own 22. Just throws this one away. Flings it right.
How did he drop that? The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly. He stepped up, and what does he do? He drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Sims is back awaiting the punt. It's away, and it's a booming punt. Sims fields it at the 30. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. 5 guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Tackle made at the 47. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Gets to around the 42. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Nice run, and he's brought down. Second and 6. Ball on the 38-yard line. Gains his way to the 30-yard line.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
They give to the tailback, and he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of three.
Yeah, it was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the junior who stepped up in traffic and made a nice play.
He fights forward to about the 26, and he gets a yard on the run.
You have to like how this linebacker was able to move up quickly and bring down the ball carrier for a short gain. Nice stop by the junior.
He just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
The kick is away. It's long enough. And he nails the long field goal.
That's a good feeling for the kicker and his teammates to know he's put this game out of reach.
Romo has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Airing it out long. And he's taken down around the 34-yard line.
Well, that's a big play by the offense. And I got to tell you, as a defense coordinator, you're blitzing, and you're taking some chances. And it's one thing to blitz and to get to the quarterback, and everybody high-fives and gets excited. But if you blitz and you don't get caught...
Touchdown, Mountaineers! And he hauls it in. And he adds the extra point. A quick two-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Boy, that is scoring in a hurry. This offense is looking more and more explosive.
He got hit hard. They were really hoping to get the ball back there.
Well, now they have to call on their defense to make something happen. They need a big play right here to get that ball back.
Well, the last drive was good for three, but I'm sure in this one they'll be looking to double that. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Hands it to the back. He's at the 20. He's all the way home. Touchdown. Well, that touchdown should just about ice this one. Splits the uprights with the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 24-yard line. So now the offense comes back out, hoping for the same success they had on their last drive.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator's got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Throws complete, and he stopped immediately. The spike will stop the clock. Third and five coming up. Ball on the 49. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Going long. And it's caught. Tackle at the 2-yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. We have less than a minute to go. Touchdown, West Virginia. The halfback just plowed his way into the end zone.
Yeah, but it wasn't all him. The offensive lineman just pancaked the defense on that one.
Trying to win the battle in the trenches, and the offense did that time. And he tacks on the extra point. He's at the 40. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. Favorite play in football of your quarterback. Take a knee. From the 41-yard line, it's second down. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. And this one's all but wrapped up. The Hokies come out on top, 27-17. So what are your final thoughts on this one, Kirk?
Virginia Tech comes away with bragging rights this year, and I'm sure the fans and students will enjoy it just as much as the players. They were the better team today and added another great chapter to this rivalry.
So that wraps things up for us. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.